Let us pray about things that we need to pray about. Holy Spirit, I just want to surrender my voice and the prayer point that I'm going to be giving out to you. Use it. Use it for every one of us. Above all, we take authority over the spirit of prayerlessness. We bind you and we cast you out. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Praise the name of the Lord. Have your seat in the presence of the Lord. If you need Genesis, perhaps I'm the only one that needs it, so don't worry. Just enjoy your eater. It's usually very hot here sometimes. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I want you to get what we are praying about this morning. We are praying about two things: vagabond spirit and here and there spirit. It looks very funny, but the two of them are in the Bible. Look at Genesis chapter 4, verse 12 and 14. Can you read it with me? Let's read together. One, two, go. When thou tillest the ground, it shall not henceforth yield unto thee as strength. A fugitive and a vagabond shall thou be in the earth. Look at verse 14. Look at verse 14. It says, read it with me, if you are with me. Behold, thou hast driven me out this day from the face of the heart, and from thy face shall I be hid, and shall I be a fugitive and a vagabond in the earth. And it shall come to pass that everyone that findeth me shall slay me. Praise the name of the Lord. So that is vagabond spirit for you. I want to paint it in the best picture that I have in my spirit as much as possible. And then I will lead us in prayer. Then I will go to here and there. I don't know if you grew up in, probably most of us didn't grow up in the west part of Nigeria, but I grew up in the west part of Nigeria. But perhaps it is possible you have heard the name of one man called Oluwalugbon. Have you heard about him before? Well, there's actually a man, King Sonny Ade or Ebenezer Obi, one of them, or Ike Dairo, sang about him. He was a motor dealer. Can you now connect? Very, very rich. I think in the 70s and the 80s. I'm not sure. But I saw him in the 90s. And the picture I saw of him is what the Lord just reminded me of this morning about vagabond spirit. This man was very rich, and he was... How many of us know Elizabeth? You know Elizabeth in Nigeria. For some of us, he's also a dealer, and he's very, very rich too. But what am I going to? One day, I was managing a company around somewhere in Ibadan. And then the driver of the company said, I don't know, we strolled out and we're just looking at the road and we saw a man. That driver is older than me, quite older than me. At that time, maybe even almost double my age. You know the scenario. So he's been around in the West for a long time. And he called my name. He said, you see that man strolling on the street of Odono? I said, yes, I don't know him. He said, have you heard about Oluwalugbon? I said, yes. He said, that is the man. I was shocked. Because I know that they place curses on people. And they will tell them that wherever they driven car to in enjoyment and pleasure, the same way they will lose their blessings and then they will walk through those paths, you know. So the picture I'm seeing right now is a picture of a vagabond spirit. You know, look at this kind of environment and look at how welfare-oriented the government is. I don't think there's any citizen or of this country that should be suffering. Do you think all the homeless people that you see on the street are not being taken care of? Ask those who are working in the supermarkets. Because some of them will come with welfare card. Voucher, yeah. Thank you. Because I've seen some of the supervisors of those supermarkets, I've related with at least one of them, and they will come with welfare cards because that card can only buy food. But they want to use it to buy drug and alcohol and cigarette. So they will come into the walk into the mall and buy food and then take it out. After 5 minutes, some of them are very sleepy. They come back into the mall and they say, oh, I bought this thing, I don't want it again. Why? They want to exchange it for cash to go and buy what is making them a vagabond in the street. So before you label me as deliverance, 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 the Holy Spirit told me yesterday, and I said, there are two ways in which people can contact vagabond spirit and the here and there spirit that we are talking about. Association and affliction. How can somebody contact it? Affliction. If it is affliction, then it is demonic. It is spiritual. If it is association, some of them, it is the kind of friends that they keep that made them to have that word, affliction of vagabond spirit. Now, my prayer for you is that vagabond spirit will not possess any one of us. And if you know anybody that has that spirit, you know, tormenting their life, tormenting their destiny, may God deliver them, and you can pray for them in this service. You understand what I'm trying to say? Now, who is a vagabond? A vagabond is a person who wanders from place to place without a home or a job. But I've just told you now that you can become a vagabond through what factors? Number one, association. Number two, affliction. Say it again. What causes a vagabond spirit to come upon people? Association. Two, affliction. Sometimes, each time I'm trying to caution my children, the kind of friends they choose, the kind of places they go, they say, I want to sleep over, I want to walk over, I want to do this over, and I'll say, naturally, we can't allow you to just do it. Do I know the homes where you're going to have the sleepover? And I keep telling them that I remember there is a boy. I know his name very well. When I was in Form 1, his name is Femi Abakan. I loved him. And he was obviously leading me astray. Obviously leading me astray. I would have become a terrible boy. I taught my math teacher, Mrs. Adewumi, who was a friend to my cousin, who was also a teacher in another school, hated me. He didn't want me to have friends. So Mr. Adewumi noticed that I was walking with her baton. And she went and reported me to my cousin. I used to call her Auntie Kike. And Auntie Kike went home and told everybody. And they ganged up at me at home and they said, you must not be a friend. You must not go with Abato again. You must not be his friend. I was saying, these people are so wicked. How can you separate my friend that he really loves me? Me too, I love him. It's cut out to some days before I start smoking. In from one. But God was massive. Maybe you know I'm going to be a pastor. Abato left our school. Because I can't see them doing it. I think God just caught that thing and Abato just left and left Ibadan and went to another school. Since today, I think I've even tried to search him on Facebook. I've not seen him again. So association and what? Affliction. So if you know anybody that is tormented or afflicted by this spirit, just find out who friend led them into it. And if you perceive a friend trying to lead somebody into a vagabond spirit, you can say, Father, cut off that relationship. Are you with me on heart of the service?
Amen.
Now let me show you the characteristics of vagabond spirit. They are usually number one, aimless. That number two, what are they?
Aimless.
Number two, they are hopeless. I still don't understand how somebody will have a package of at least, I don't know how much they give them per week, and somebody will be sleeping on the street in this cold. I've met so many that I've given my number to that I've tried to preach to. They are aimless, they are hopeless. Number three, they are careless. Number four, they are helpless. Number five, they are usually worthless and useless. And that's why you must pray against any manifestation of aimlessness in your life, hopelessness in your life, carelessness in your life, helplessness in your life, or any spirit that makes you to feel worthless or useless. Because it is the offspring of vagabond spirit. Rise to your feet. What is the danger of continuing with a vagabond spirit? Death and physical destruction. What did I say? What is the danger of continuing with vagabond spirit? Death and physical destruction. Look at what happened to this man said in verse 14. Thank you. You got it. Let's read it together. Rise up on your feet. Behold, thou hast driven me this day from the face of the earth, and from thy face shall I be hid, and I shall be a fugitive. So another spirit that you can call it is what? A fugitive spirit, and a vagabond in the earth. And it shall come to pass, if I am not delivered from this spirit of fugitive, of vagabond spirit, that everyone that find me shall slay me. Ultimately, somebody that is under the torment or the affliction of a vagabond spirit will die untimely. It is not because I preach it. It is been established. Very soon, notice, do your own analysis. Somebody that you see walks around aimlessly, hopelessly, carelessly, and helplessly, and worthlessly, very soon you will not see them again, and you just hear that maybe a car crushed them or something just happened to them and they die. Say, my father, my father.
My father, my father.
Now we're going to be throwing the prayer point. Say, my father, my father.
My father.
Over my life. Over my... Do you know those? Some of those people are somebody's children. Some of them, it is even cocaine addiction, drug addiction. Some of them come from rich homes. Do you know there are celebrities that vagabond spirits send them back to the streets in America, all over the world? So you are going to pray and say, my father, my father. Every vagabond spirit upon the trying to come upon my life, trying to come upon my hope, or trying to come upon any member of my family, in the name of Jesus Christ, in the name of Jesus Christ, I rebuke that spirit in their life. I rebuke that spirit. Make sure you are praying. I rebuke that spirit in their life. I rebuke that spirit in their life. Every vagabond spirit that is working in Christ Church, that is working in Christ Church, that is working upon the hearts of men, that is working upon the minds of youths, I rebuke them in the name of Jesus. Every vagabond spirit that is operating in my family life, I rebuke it in the name of Jesus. Every vagabond spirit that is trying to come upon me, I rebuke you in the name of Jesus. I rebuke you in the name of Jesus. I rebuke you in the name of Jesus. I want you to begin to pray. Vagabond spirit, you will not have a way in my life. Vagabond spirit, you will not have a way in my family. Vagabond spirit, you will not have a way in my church. Vagabond spirit,
You will not have a way in my spirit, in my street, vagabond spirit. Rabako shete keyerebo zonda raba shete keyerebo raba baba baba shende rebo kuriya basanda rahat rima shende rebo sota kaliya basende rehe. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray.
Amen.
I'm not joking. You just need to be around the city center or go to some spots in Christ Church overnight. Every Friday, I've seen it several times, every Saturday, you will see teenagers. They are just walking about on the street till 4 a.m. Sometimes I wonder, where are their parents? They are sleeping. And their spirit and their children are wandering about. It's not all of them that will end up on the street. Some of them will get taken back from the street. But in future life, that spirit will bring them back to the street. Therefore, you are going to pray for Christ's church and say, Father, over all youth and teenagers in Christ's church. Don't forget, you know, one of our brothers in the fellowship yesterday said something. He said, that's Bro Manuel. He said something yesterday that touched me. He said, somebody said, when your prayer that you are praying is answered, will it be a testimony that God changed you or God changed your world? So don't pray for yourself alone. Pray for the city. Say, Father, over every youth, over every teenager in Christ Church, we come against vagabond spirit to the west of this city, Lord, to the north of this city, to the south of this city, to the east of this city. We come against vagabond spirit. We pray on behalf of parents that are crying secretly because this spirit is tormenting their children. We begin to rebuke vagabond spirit. We begin to rebuke vagabond spirit in the name of Jesus. Lord, we rebuke vagabond spirit in the name of Jesus. Lord, we rebuke vagabond spirit in the name of Jesus. Lord, we rebuke vagabond spirit over the lives of the teenagers in this land. Reboso tataliba shende rebo. Reboso takaliba shende rehe. Lebo shende rebo kuri abasanda rahat. We rebuke vagabond spirit. We rebuke vagabond spirit. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. You need to know how painful it is for a parent to watch their children slide into vagabond spirit. When a child does not want to stay at home, and just delights in walking about the streets. It happens everywhere. Do you know their church, their children, when I was growing up, that the moment they get to school, they change into another clothes. And they say, pam, they are gone out of the school. One of such students, one day, I saw him, he was a bus conductor in my city. That's what vagabond spirit does to people. And his teeth is dark. And some of his teeth are even gone. Have you seen your classmate like that? And you're wondering. The boss that I work with one day, one man, always drunken. I don't want to waste your time. Say in the name of Jesus. Every parent in this city, in this country, who is pain in their heart, because the vagabond spirit is upon their children. Lord, we send your comfort. Deliver their children from vagabond spirit. And oh Lord, every parent represented in this church, Lord, let none of our children be afflicted by vagabond spirit. They will go into the street, they will drink into, even girls will drink. They will drink and be drunken, and they will have to look for Uber to take them home. They can't control themselves. They don't know what they are doing again. Father, we come against vagabond spirit. Father, we come against vagabond spirit. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Let's begin to deal with the offshoot of it. Say, every aimless spirit.
Amen.
Trying to afflict me. Trying to afflict my family. and trying to afflict anyone in form of vagabond spirit. Spirit of aimlessness, I rebuke you in the name of Jesus. I rebuke you in the name of Jesus. I rebuke you, I rebuke you, I rebuke you, I rebuke you, I rebuke you. Aimlessness, aimlessness, aimlessness is one of the offspring of vagabond spirit. We rebuke you, we rebuke you in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, aimlessness, we rebuke you. In the name of Jesus. Keep praying, keep praying, keep praying, keep praying, keep praying, keep praying. Lima sendere bokoli abashendere he. We rebuke aimlessness in the name of Jesus. Keep praying, 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 keep praying. My Father, my God, in the name of Jesus. Rabba sendere yele boshendere he. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Every hopelessness spirit, in the name of Jesus, over my life, over my nation, over this city, over this church, we rebuke you in the name of Jesus, for you are the offspring of vagabond spirit. We rebuke you in the name of Jesus. You will not come upon my children. Will you not come upon my brothers? You will not come upon my sisters. Hopelessness, hopelessness. When somebody slides into hopelessness, it's about to be afflicted with vagabond spirit. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, in Jesus' name we pray. Carelessness. Careless spirit is one of the offshoots of vagabond spirits. I'm sorry to say, it is not proper for children to live in a room that is look like a madhouse, like a hill. It's not proper. The human brain is not programmed that way. So when you see somebody that you enter their room and nothing is in order, it is not proper. So therefore, you are going to pray and say, Father, today I rebuke every affliction of carelessness in my life. In the name of Jesus, open your mouth and pray. I rebuke our family members in the name of Jesus. Rabba sote ke yelebo sota kaliba shendere he. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Another manifestation of this vagabond spirit is worthlessness. They just don't feel they worth anything. The day they realize that they are worth more than who they think they are, they will leave the streets. So that is why you're going to pray and say, Father, every roaming spirit of worthlessness, afflicting men in my city, afflicting men in my family, in the name of Jesus, I come against you, I come against you, I come against you, I come against you, I come against you. Rabba baba ba shete ke yele bo zonda kali ba shendere he. Rabba baba shete ke yele bo zonda la ba shendere he. In the name of Jesus, I come against you, I come against you, I come against you, I come against you. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. I didn't release them in full. But you know, when vagabond spirit becomes chronic, it makes them to become graceless and heartless. That's when they become hardened criminals. May you not meet them in Oshodi if you pass through the place. You know what I'm saying. Those people, they have been toughened by life circumstances. So because of full of 5,000 naira, do you know they have killed people? When we bought our church bus and went to clear it in Apapa in Lagos, I couldn't allow anybody to drive it. I was the one driving it. One huge bus like this with glasses all around it. And then we got to Oshodoki. And there was hold up. I was not used to, I've never experienced it before. All of a sudden, some boys just came out. They noticed it was a brand new bus. And they came out. And they said, give us money. And I was like, what does this want me? I said, give us money. And I was like, what? Before I need, one of them told us, he said, if you don't give us money, before you move out of this ghost, we will break the glasses of this bus.
I don't know where I said, I was calling one person, I said, please give me some money. And the moment I gave them the money, they disappeared. Say, Father, every gracelessness and artlessness upon our youth, upon our city, brought about by vagabond spirit, we rebuke you in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, pray for yourself that I will not be graceless. I will not be heartless. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. I know you don't have much familiarity with what I've just dealt with, but we'll go to one that you'll get familiar with. Now go to Psalm 109. Let's use it to pray. Let his children be continually vagabonds and beg. Let them seek their bread also out of desolate places. Are you with me? Let's read it together. Want to go? Say, let his children be continually vagabonds and beg. And let them seek their bread out of their desolate places. Say, Father. Say, my Father, my Father. I stand for my children and for my generation born and unborn. Let no vagabond spirit make them beggars in the name of Jesus. I stand for my children. I stand for my generation born and unborn. Pray. In the name of Jesus, let no vagabond spirit make them beggars. Make them beggars in the name of Jesus. That shows you that vagabond spirit makes people to beg. In the name of Jesus, Lord, I stand in the gap. Lord, I stand in the gap for my children. Pray for your children and for your children born and unborn. Let no vagabond spirit make them beggars. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Acts of the Apostles chapter 19. Now, do you know there are spiritual vagabonds? In the name of Jesus, you will not be one. Verse 13 says, and certain of the vagabond Jews, exorcists, took upon them to call upon over them which have evil spirit, the name of the Lord Jesus, saying, we are joined by Jesus whom Paul preached. Anyone that is familiar with the name of Jesus, but Jesus is not Lord in their heart, but attempts to take advantage of the name of Jesus, is a spiritual vagabond. You will never exercise spiritual authority that way. Say, Father of life, deliver our churches from vagabond children. In the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and pray. Deliver our churches from vagabond spirits. Deliver our churches from vagabond spirits. In the name of Jesus. All these social media news. We know one pastor. He belongs to one denomination. He impregnated the daughter. He impregnated the mother at the same time. He impregnated seven sisters. Those are vagabond in the church. Father, deliver our church from vagabond spirit. In the name of Jesus. Pray. Make sure you are praying. In the name of Jesus. Make sure you are praying. Father, deliver our church from vagabond spirit. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Don't pray this one sitting there, right? It says, sitting down. Stand to your feet and say, Father. Anoint me.
Anoint me.
Put your hand on your head and say, Father. Anoint me to cast out vagabond spirit. In the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and pray. Lord, anoint me. Anoint me to cast out vagabond spirit. In the name of Jesus. Anoint me to cast out vagabond spirit. In the name of Jesus. Anoint me to deal with vagabond spirit. In the name of Jesus. Anoint me. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. Rise to your feet and pray, children. Rise to your feet. Say, Father. Anointing that no vagabond spirit can torment. Say, my father, the anointing that no vagabond spirit can torment, put it upon my life in the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and pray. The anointing that no vagabond spirit can
can, oh God, overcome. Put it upon me, put it upon me, put it upon me. Ask for that anointing. The anointing that no vagabond spirit can overcome. Put it upon me, put it upon me, put it upon me, put it upon me. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Say, my father, the summit of spirit to identify. Vagabond spirit, release it unto me in a name. Listen. When you see it and you are able to discern it early in any situation, in any person, you can deal with it instantly. You got me? Say, Father, discernment to identify vagabond spirit in the name of Jesus. Put it upon me, put it upon me, put it upon me in the name of Jesus. Discernment to identify vagabond spirit, put it upon me in Jesus' mighty name. We pray. Now sit down. Let's go to the second one. Here and their spirit. First Kings chapter 20. You know all these things that I'm saying, I didn't get them from my head. They are from the scriptures. First Kings chapter 20 verse 40. Are you there? Okay, let's read it together. It says, as thy servant was busy. Let's read it one. Let's read it, church. As thy servant was busy. Let's go to verse 39 quickly. You understand it better. It says, and as the king passed by, he cried unto the king and said, thy servant went out into the midst of the battle, and behold, a man turned aside and brought a man unto me, and said, keep this man, if by any means he be missing, then shall thy life be for his life, or else thou shalt pay a talent of silver. Verse 40. Read it, church. And as thy servant was busy here and there, he was gone. And the king of Israel said unto him, so shall thy judgment be, thy servant has decided it. Now, here and there spirit is very, very common to believers. It's very, very common to everybody. And it's closer to vagabond spirit, but it's not vagabond spirit. If you are looking for somebody that manifested vagabond spirit, I was one. How can you imagine somebody waking up and saying, I want to be an artist? After some years, I said, I want to be a farmer. After some years, I was studying to become an architect. And then eventually, when God just made sure that everything collapse, and now said God. I didn't know it was here and there spirit. God, can you just show me what you want me to do? And for the first time, accounting was laid in my heart. And ever I've been happy. In fact, I'm tired of studying accounting. Praise the name of the Lord. I wish I can study something else. Maybe my brain will wake up a little bit. Now, when you see somebody today, you want to be this. Tomorrow you change, I want to be that. Yesterday, you wanted to be this. Tomorrow you wanted to be that. You see, there's only one thing and that will make you not to have a here and there spirit. You need to discover it. So, listen to this. Five things I want you to know about here and there spirit. You can be busy doing nothing. How some people do this, I don't know. But this is what God told me. You can be busy doing nothing. Do you know some, you know, I know some housewives, when their husband leave the house in the morning, I'm just having that picture because I said, God, how can somebody be busy doing nothing? And God put that picture in my mind and I'm going to describe it to you. Their housewife, they don't work, it's their husband that works. And then they wake up in the morning and then by the time the husband comes, he said, I've been very, very busy. The kitchen is still dirty. I've been very, very busy. All the clothes she's supposed to wash, she has not washed it. I've been very, very busy. She only swept the house. And you know, have you seen somebody, you carry bucket from the kitchen, you put it in the room. And then you went to the bathroom to be doing something else. And then you came back and you remember that the bucket you took from the kitchen, you are not supposed to put it in the room. You wanted to take it to the what? Bathroom. So you picked it from the room and then somebody knocked on the door. And then you went to your balcony and you were talking to the person. You put the bucket in the balcony. And then you finished talking and chatting with the person for 1 hour. You went back inside.
What is the object of here and their spirit? The bucket has not reached its destination. That's an example of being busy with nothing. Number two, you can be busy doing the wrong thing. You are busy. Yes. See, the people that complain that I am too busy are the people that psychologically we are told that waste time most. Each time you tell them, come and do something, I am busy, I am busy, I am, what are you busy about? You don't even know. So you can be busy, but you are busy doing the wrong thing. I guess that one you will understand it. Number three, you can be busy doing the right thing with the wrong people at the wrong time in a wrong place. It's still a manifestation of here and their spirit. You are busy, but you are busy doing the right thing with the wrong people at the wrong time in a wrong place. Don't forget Jehoshaphat, who made affliction with Ahab. And they wanted to send sheep to Tarshish. What happened to it? It collapsed. Because he was doing the right thing with the wrong person. I wish you don't waste this one. Quickly, say, Father.
Father.
Deliver me from being busy.
Deliver me from being
with the wrong people. With the right people. At the wrong time. In the wrong place. Those are the prayer points. Number four. You can now be busy rightly. In other words, you are busy doing the right thing at the right time with the right people. And it is cut across all spheres of our life. Business, church, everything. And when I say you are busy rightly, it means you are the only one and the right one. That's what you are doing. What is the risk factor in here and there spirit? Here and there spirit can make you lose divine opportunities and waste divine timing. Here and there spirit can make you to achieve in 20 years what you are supposed to achieve in 2 years. Here and there spirit can set you back. For as long as you don't realize that you are under the spirit of here and there. You know, it's very easy in this land. You know, that's why a lot of people don't go to school, because every trade, every profession has internal certification. Care job, they have internal certification. Baba, they have internal certification. Which one? All of them, they have their own internal certification. Am I right? Chef, they have internal certification. Security, they have internal certification. So when some of the kids come out, and I remember I was discussing with one of our brothers, and he was saying that there's somebody that is earning, that never went to university, and is earning close to $100 per hour, doing a cleaning, a special kind of cleaning job. And he's not ready to leave that job because he's been there for years. He's not doing here and there. He knows that if he leaves that job, he can't get anything in any other industry, and they will give him $100. He's going to start again. What makes you think that you do this? You can survive in this kind of economy doing different jobs in 3 years without defining which one you want to stick your destiny to. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So here and there spirit can make us lose divine opportunity and waste divine timing. An example of somebody with here and there spirit, Martha. Look at Luke chapter 10 verse 40 to 42 quickly. We'll just roll the prayer point. We still have 15 minutes quickly. He said, but Martha was cumbered about much serving and came to him and said, Lord, that does care. Please, can you tell that, take him away from the curtain. And came to him and said, Lord, that has care that my sister hath left me to serve alone. Be her therefore that she helped me. And she thought Jesus would rebuke the sister. And Jesus answered and said unto Martha, Martha, you have been careful and troubled and about many things, be busy about many things. And Jesus said unto her, one thing is needful, and Mary has chosen that good part which shall not be taken away from her. I pray that God will reveal to you the only thing and the right thing.
Amen.
God will reveal to you the only thing and the right thing.
Amen.
I said God will reveal to you the only thing and the right thing.
Amen.
Stop experimenting with your destiny. Start pursuing and living for your purpose and your calling alone. How do you contact the virus? Association and what? Affliction. What did I say? Association and affliction. I don't know how many kind of unskilled job offers I've rejected in this land. In my spirit, I would be telling myself, no, no. What can I be jumping about? Praise the name of the Lord. Here and there, spirit will not cut your destiny short in the name of Jesus. Say, rise to your feet and quickly pray this prayer point as we close this service. Say, my Father, my Father.
My father.
Let's start from the good one. Say, my Father, my Father.
My Father.
Deliver my life from every association afflicting my life with here and there spirit. In the name of Jesus, deliver my life from every association. From every association. It can even be your spouse that is advising you wrongly. And they're just advising you from their mind. They're just advising you because of money alone. What about future? What about destiny? What about purpose? Therefore, say in the name of Jesus, I'm not saying God will deliver you from your spouses, but I'm praying that God will open your eyes to understand that that here and there spirit will not continue to control your life in the name of Jesus. But if there are external demonic associations, if there are unpleasant associations that God has not proposed for your life, may God separate you from every association that is afflicting your destiny with here and there spirit. Open your mouth and pray in the name of Jesus. Deliver my heart, deliver my life, deliver my heart, deliver my heart. Open your mouth and pray. Deliver my heart, deliver my life from every association that is going to afflict my life with here and there spirit. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Hold somebody's hand. Say, my Father, my Father. Deliver my brother, deliver my sister from every association and affliction that is imposing here and there spirit upon them. In the name of Jesus, deliver my brother. Pray. Make sure you are praying for them. Deliver my brother, deliver my sister from every association that is imposing on their destiny, the here and there spirit. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, deliver them, 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 deliver them. In the name of Jesus, be delivered, be delivered. Make sure you are praying. Deliver my brother, deliver my sister from every association that is imposing on them, the here and there spirit. In the name of she kaliba sandala high. In Jesus' name we pray. Deliver my heart from every lost, through every lost, tending towards here and there. In the name of Jesus, deliver my heart, deliver my heart. Hold that person's hand and pray for them. And deliver the heart of this person whose hand I'm holding from every loss towards here and their spirit. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Let me give you a very perfect example. Like, you know, I've discovered that accounting is very big in this land. So you can't just be aimless. There's asset management. There's financial accounting. There's taxation. There's financial analysis. There's finance itself. Several aspects. And I've discovered that people rise in rank because they do one thing for a long time. So don't try to do everything. Maybe that will bless somebody. Let's quickly pray and say, my Father, my Father, deliver my life from being busy with nothing. Open your mouth and deliver my brother from being busy with nothing. Open your mouth, hold that person's hand. Are you tired? They are not really prayed. Say, deliver my life from being busy with nothing. And deliver the hands of this person that I'm holding from being busy with nothing. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. I'm sorry to say, something came to my heart. You know, I went after 1 year in this land, I said I wanted to do my PhD. And I wrote to UC, and the lady that replied me offended me. But do you know, my sense is telling me now that perhaps the God allowed that lady to insult me. Because some people are doing PhD, you don't really need it. And then she said, you are this, you are this, you have this qualification, you have this qualification, you are appointed professionally. So what do you need a PhD for? And I read the mail to my wife and I said, What is this woman's business? Can you just abuse me this way? But that was the end of that dream in my heart. But do you know that you can get involved in something that you don't really need? Say, my father, deliver my destiny from being busy with the wrong thing. In the name of Jesus. Deliver my life from being busy with the wrong thing. Deliver my life from being busy with the wrong thing. Open your mouth and pray. Deliver my life from being busy with the wrong thing. Are you praying? Deliver my life from being busy with the wrong thing. Deliver my life from being busy with the wrong thing. Open your mouth and pray. Rabasanda kali bashendere bozo kali abashendere. Deliver my life from being busy with the wrong thing. Deliver my life from being busy with the wrong thing. Oh Lord, deliver my life from being busy with the wrong thing. Deliver my wife, deliver my daughters, deliver my family, deliver every member of this church from being busy with the wrong thing. If you know your cousins, if you know your siblings, in the name of Jesus, some of them trouble you for money, it is because they are busy doing the wrong thing. Lord, deliver my family from being busy with the wrong thing. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
We can be busy doing the right thing with the wrong people. Say, Father of life, deliver my life from being busy with the with the right thing and the wrong people. Open your mouth and pray. In the name of Jesus, deliver my life from being busy with the right thing but wrong people. In the name of Jesus, deliver my life from being busy with the right thing but wrong people. Deliver my life from being busy with the right thing but the wrong people. Deliver my life from being busy with the right thing for wrong people. Deliver my life. In the name of Jesus, pray. I wish you are praying more than you are praying. Deliver my life from being busy with the wrong thing. From being busy with the right thing, with the wrong people. In Jesus' name we pray. Some people travel in marriage for 10 years, 30 years. And they keep patching it before they realize that they are busy marrying with the wrong person. So before you marry, make sure you get it right. Marriage is more than the wedding day. Say, deliver my life from doing the right thing at the wrong time. Open your mouth and pray. Deliver my life from doing the right thing at the wrong time. Because it's going to end up in failure. Deliver my life from doing the right thing at the wrong time. Open your mouth and pray. Deliver my life from doing the right thing at the wrong time. Deliver my life from doing the right thing at the wrong time. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Say, deliver my life from doing the right thing in the wrong place. Open your mouth and pray. Lord, deliver my life from doing the right thing in the wrong place. Lord, deliver my life from doing the right thing in the wrong place. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Do you know there is a spirit that is disturbing you from praying? I'm not used to rebuking people, but I feel like rebuking is sharply. Don't let the devil cheat you. Since I declared this August prayer, there's a lackadaisical spirit in some of you. They're just walking about. They're just shaking your head. I pray you will not regret it.
Amen.
Stand to your feet and pray. I'm not used to rebuking people. And you know I don't do that. There's too much distraction in the church, in the service. And it's obvious that you're not praying from your heart. And you know you need it. And even if you don't need it now, you will need it. Because there is no man that the devil will not tempt to be busy with nothing. Lord, say my father. Let me give you the opportunity. Say my father. Deliver my life from doing the right thing at the wrong time and the wrong place. Open your mouth and pray. Deliver my life from doing the wrong thing at the right thing at the wrong time with the wrong people at the wrong place in the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and pray. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Now, finally, hold somebody's hand. Please, when it's posted on YouTube, listen to it again And in your private moment, please, from your heart. You see, let me tell you this. In 2000, when was it? 2004. I want to tell you the power of prayers. I listened to my bishop on surviving the hour of darkness. It's one of the greatest prayer sermon I've ever had in my life. We had accommodation issues, so we were staying with a professor who put us in his professor Sonwo, and we're managing one room apartment. Yet church members are still living with us. And I prayed that prayer. I prayed that prayer until I slept off, 2004. And I had a dream. I saw that the city where we are living, something happened. And I was looking for my children, surviving the hour of darkness. And I was looking for my children. And I hurriedly got a taxi, and I put my family, and I ran out of the city. Did I share the vision with you? When my wife was attacked in the university where she was lecturing, was it 2010? The Lord reminded me the vision is about to come to pass. The student said, they are coming to kill her. They tried to kill them. And some of you know, there's a lady in town on Simi. The father was a professor. She was with my wife. The two of them, they were to be killed in OU that day. Because the professor was driving the escape. And the student said, because they are not going to use service, they said they are coming to our house to come and kill my wife. And I collected the phone from them. I became angry. You know, that 2010, I've never ministered before. And people will be falling in the service. But that day, when I remember that vision, I gathered two brothers together. They said they are coming. I took all the three vehicles in our compound. I went to park it in a friend's house. Said, if they are coming, I took my children, I went to put them there. I prayed one prayer I've never prayed before in my life overnight. The following Sunday morning, I thought they would come and meet us in church, because I said, if you come, if you cross the territory of this city, all of you will be wiped out. I told them on the phone. So I told my wife, I said, I'm not moving out of this house, let them come and meet me. They will die spiritually. I don't know how God is going to do it. I was that determined. I prayed a prayer I've never prayed before. The following Sunday, for the first time in my life, I was in the service, I was just leading prayer, and people were just being slain in the spirit. Because I so much drenched myself that night. Because 6 years ago, I saw it surviving the hour of darkness. You may not need a prayer point now. But the day you will need it, may you remember that you prayed through.
Amen.
About it.
Amen.
Finally say, my Father, my Father.
My Father.
Deliver my brother and my sister from vagabond spirit and here and there spirit. Let it not waste their future. Deliver my brother, deliver my sister from vagabond spirit and here and there spirit. In the name of Jesus. Deliver my brother, deliver my sister from vagabond spirit and here and there spirit. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
We're going to sing that song quickly. Do we have the time? We don't have the time. Don't worry. We'll leave it that way. Let's bow down our heads to pray. Let's give God the glory because He has answered our prayer. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Stretch forth your hands and pray for me. And give God the glory because you know God has answered.
Hello everyone. Thank you for listening to today's message. We hope you've been blessed. Please don't keep it to yourself. Share it with your contacts and don't forget to like and subscribe to this YouTube channel. Stay blessed.